Hi, let's talk about the cardiac veins. In this video, we'll really focus on the greater system. So we won't be discussing the Thebesian veins. We'll talk about the veins that are quite superficial and very evident from a gross perspective. And let's begin with the great cardiac vein. You can see a little bit of the great cardiac vein. Let me just change colors here to really honor our venous brothers and sisters. Here you can see it ascending up. Typically, it's more superficial than the anterior interventricular branch, but it's occupying that same niche of the generalized region of the anterior interventricular sulcus. So it will be a sulcus buddy with the anterior interventricular branch. Now, as we wrap around into the coronary sulcus, now we're on the posterior, inferior portion of the heart. So this is the diaphragmatic surface there. We can see the base of the heart there. Here is the opening for the inferior vena cava. Here's our coronary sulcus there. Let's see what we can see, so to speak. So let me erase all of this. And coming around that corner where we left off in the coronary sulcus is that great cardiac vein, and it's emptying into this very large dilated vessel called the coronary sinus. The coronary sinus lives in the coronary sulcus, and it is the collecting vein of the greater system before it heads into the right atrium. So in the posterior interventricular sulcus, which we can see coming up here, we have a middle cardiac vein. So the great is coming around there. The middle comes around there. We're going to have a small come around that way, but we're going to have to approach that from a different perspective. The small cardiac vein is going to be in association with the right marginal branch. We can see that snaking along there, helping to drain the right ventricle. And while we're at this orientation, we can also see some of my favorite cardiac veins. They're my favorite cardiac veins because they really buck the system, the greater system, that is. Because most greater system veins are going to drain into the coronary sinus, these anterior cardiac veins help to drain the right ventricle, and they are going to independently enter into the right atrium. And there can generally be between 3 to 5 anterior cardiac veins. And as you dissect, typically, you know, I recommend dissecting in the direction of vasculature, but as you dissect through the epicardium, at least at this coronary sulcus here, I'd recommend dissecting in this direction so that you can first find these anterior cardiac veins and preserve them before you dig out the right coronary artery. So these are the cardiac veins, named so because they drain the myocardium, or the heart, of blood. We've discussed the coronary sinus and the great, middle, and small cardiac veins, which drain into it, as well as the anterior cardiac veins, which do not drain into it. Thank you very much for your time.